Ostwald's dilution law. So I'll write the statement. Statement for this law is what it says is that degree of dissociation is inversely proportional. Inversely proportional to square root of concentration. Means what it says is that more the dilution, more is the degree of dissociation. Like laws, I will write the law alpha is equal to square root of K by C. This is for a weak acid. This is what I have written is for a weak acid. Right? And here for weak base, alpha is equal to what? Square root of KB by C. Okay, KB by C. So this is for weak base. KB is a dissociation constant for a basis and K is a dissociation constant for a acids. So this is what it rules. This is what the rule is. So let's understand this rule. We'll derive this because derivation is very important from the numericals and the questions asked. Let's take a weak acid. I'll explain you for the weak acid. You can derive it for the weak basis also later. So let's start this. For a weak acid. HA. Let's assume that HA is a weak acid. Okay, so I'll write over here HA liquid water. It will split as what? H plus aqueous and A minus aqueous. This is what you are getting. So initially at time t is equal to 0, what is this? This is let's say x moles. This is x mole. Okay, this water is in excess, a large amount. Okay, like 10 liter of water, then this is 1 milligram or 1 gram this way. So this is water is in excess. So this is 0 and this is 0. So at time t is equal to equilibrium, what would be this? X minus what I'll write is X alpha. Okay, I'll explain this. And here I'll write X alpha and this is X alpha. Now what is alpha? Alpha is the degree of dissociation. Alpha is a degree of dissociation. Dissociation means alpha is a number of molecules dissociated upon total number of molecules. You can write this in another way also. Number of moles getting dissociated upon total number of moles, right? So number of molecules dissociated upon total number of the molecules. So here let's say this is HA, which is a weak acid. Weak acid means very few things are going to get dissociated. No, so this is, let's say here there are 100. Initially there are 100 molecules. Don't worry about this mole and all. Just see this. This is 100. Out of 100, just 5 are getting dissociated. So what is alpha? Alpha is equal to 5 upon 100. That is 0.05. Let's say out of 100, 50 are getting dissociated. So alpha is what? 50 upon 100. If total number of the molecule is 100, then answer is 0.5. Okay. If all the molecules are getting dissociated, alpha, what I say is that this is not a weak, let's say if it is not weak, if it is a strong like HCl, if it is a HCl and if you put this into water, right? So you get H plus and a Cl minus, means initially this is 100. When I was defining a weak acid and a strong acid, I had told you this. If this is 100, initially this will be 0. At time t is equal to equilibrium, this will be 0 and this is 100 and 100. Means everything is getting splitted off. Means here it is 100 upon 100. So what is alpha? Alpha is equal to 1, right? This is for a strong electrolyte. So what we can say is that maximum value of alpha is equal to 1 and
when alpha is equal to, when alpha is tending to one or very close to one, it is a strong electrolyte. It is a strong electrolyte, right? But our thing is over here, it is not strong electrolyte, so it is a weak electrolyte, right? Weak electrolyte means obviously alpha is not is equal to one over here. Remember this. Since it is a weak electrolyte, alpha is not is equal to one. So just imagine, no, if you just put this, if it was a strong electrolyte, you put one over here. So x minus x, it will become, and this will become zero, and this will become x and x. Means this is true in a strong electrolyte. So alpha is not is equal to one. So here this is representing the number of moles over here. So let's write the equilibrium constant. How you are going to write an equilibrium constant for this? See, base is this only. We start with this equilibrium constant. K is equal to concentration of the H plus and a concentration of the A minus upon concentration of the HA and a concentration of the H2O, right? So what I do is K, and this concentration of water, since water is in large excess, concentration of water is not going to change, right? It is almost constant. Just imagine a 1000 ml of water is there, or one liter of water is there, and very little amount of the in micrograms you are putting something into that, it's not going to change its concentration. So this is also a constant, this is also a constant. We call this to be a K. Let's write this later. This is H plus, and this is A minus, and this is H A. So this is forming a new constant, because this concentration of water is also constant. In terms of acid, we call this to be a K. See, any constant, K A, K B, K C, K P, it is, everything is derived from what? It is derived from equilibrium constant only, right? So this is this will become what? This will become, what is the concentration of the H plus? How we are going to write a concentration? So this I write K is equal to concentration of the H plus concentration of A minus upon HA. Hope it is coming into the frame. Yes, lot of space is there. So what is K is equal to? What is the concentration of the H plus? Let's say this is in a certain volume V. So number of moles of A, what is the number of moles of H plus? This is the number of moles. So X alpha upon V multiplied by X alpha upon V. This is a number, this is a concentration now telling. This is also, it is telling you about the concentration. And what is the concentration of HA? Concentration of XA? This is X minus X alpha upon V. Right? So therefore K is equal to, let's solve this quickly, X square alpha square V square into V upon X minus X alpha. Right? If I rearrange it this way, then this here, this V and this one of the V, so X square alpha square, and what I do is I take X common from here, so 1 minus alpha, this and this will get cancelled, that is KA. Therefore KA is equal to alpha square upon 1 minus alpha, and this is X. I think something I am missing over here is, yeah, one of the V, X by V, right? So here I can write this K is equal to alpha square, 1 minus V could be written as just 1, okay? Because alpha is a degree of dissociation. In the case of weak electrolyte, it is very very less, 0.05, 0.009, it is very very less in front of the 1. So I can ignore this. 1 minus alpha could be written as directly is equal to 1, right? And this is what on the new X by V. What is this X by V? X tells you about the number of moles of the this number of moles of the weak electrolyte upon volume. Means this will be what? K is equal to, I will write this to be a alpha square C, right? So therefore alpha is equal to what? Square root of K by C. This is the thing which we can derive for a weak electrolyte. This is for a weak electrolyte, weak acid I mean. This is for a weak acid we are deriving. Same way for the weak base, I'll not derive that weak base. Alpha is equal to square root of KB by C. Yeah, this is what whole Ostwald's dilution law is.
So here let's we'll define the terms also. So we are having this with respect to this, with respect to this weak acid. What is Ka is equal to? Ka is equal to, it is dissociation constant, dissociation constant for weak acid. Alpha is degree of dissociation, degree of dissociation. And what is C? It is initial concentration, initial concentration of weak acid. Same way the other formula will be there. Alpha is equal to KB by C. So this question is there, CH3COH, which is a weak acid, everyone knows that. Means this is going to split this way, CH3COOH, this is going to split in water as CH3COO minus aqueous plus H plus aqueous, right? So first thing we are told to find alpha. We know that directly alpha is equal to what? Square root of K by C. K is given, K for this is given to be alpha is equal to, K is given to be 10 raised to minus 5. What is C? C is the initial concentration, which is 10. So this is 10. So alpha is equal to square root of how much this will become? 10 raised to minus 6. Alpha is equal to 10 raised to minus 3, right? Square root of 10 raised to minus 6 is 10 raised to minus 3. Now second thing is square bracket of the H plus, means what? A concentration of the H plus is asked. So here just understand this. So initial is C, so this is 0 and 0, right? At time t is equal to, I'll write this way. So at time t is equal to equilibrium, equilibrium, when the equilibrium is attained, is C into C minus alpha. Understand this. If alpha is 1, that is true only in the case of strong electrolyte, this term will become 0, means everything will get dissociated. But this is weak acid, alpha is not is equal to 1, it is very very less than 1. So this is C minus C alpha, and this is C alpha and a C alpha. Now this represents a concentration, this represents a concentration of the H plus. So concentration of the H plus is what? C alpha, no? So what is C? C is 10. And what is the alpha value? Alpha value we are getting to be 10 raised to minus 3. So concentration of the H plus over here is 10 raised to minus 2. Just understand, you know, so much, 10 molar was the concentration of the weak electrolyte, weak acid, that is acetic acid. So much was the concentration, and how much you are getting when you put that into water? It is very very less compared to this. It is 0.001. So you can understand that weak acid is so weak that hardly any dissociation takes place over here, right? 10 molar was the initial concentration, means you are getting this 10 to minus 2, means very little amount of the H plus, very little amount of the dissociation has taken place. So that's why concentration of H plus is very very less. But just imagine if you had taken a 10 molar of HCl, if you had taken in this case, if it was 10 molar of HCl, what would have been the case? This would have been H plus and a Cl minus, means 10 molar means you should get approximately 10 molar of this, means maximum of the H plus you should get. So that is what the concept is. We'll solve one more question. So find out the value of alpha if find out the value of alpha of 10 raised to minus 2 molar HCN. HCN is a weak acid. So what will happen? HCN, when you put this into water, you will get H plus aqueous and a CN minus aqueous, right? So let's say C is the concentration, initial concentration of the HCN. This is at time t is equal to 0, and this is 0 and this is 0 initial. So at time t equilibrium, I'm writing at equilibrium, this will be what? C minus C alpha, and this is C alpha and a C alpha. Just imagine if it was 2H plus, you would have written 2 C alpha. Understand that, okay? So here it is C alpha and C alpha. So what is the thing? They have given the concentration of the H plus. Find out alpha. How to find from this? Means concentration of H plus is this, concentration of the H plus, this represents the concentration of H plus C alpha. So concentration of the H plus is what? 10 raised to minus 2. What is C? Initial concentration of the H plus, is 10 raised to minus 2. Sorry, this is 10 raised to minus 3, no? Yes. This is 10 raised to minus 3 and this is 10 raised to minus 2. So what is alpha? Alpha is equal to what? 10 raised to minus 3 divided by 10 raised to minus 2, which is equal to 10 raised to minus 1. So therefore, alpha is what? 0.1. You have to keep the track of one thing is that alpha cannot go more than 1. Okay, it will be always less than 1. Maximum value of the alpha is 1. That is for the strong electrolyte. So this is 0.01, means just 10%. Yes, 0.01 means it is 10%. Alpha in percentage, it is 10%. Means only 10% of this is getting dissociated. That is what it means. If you take 100 molecule, only 10 will be H plus ion. If you take 1000 molecule, only 100 H plus ion will be there. That is what it means. Dissociation constant.